Shalom, daughters of Sarah. So this is the chicken pot pie recipe. As you can see, this is the finished product. Okay, looks yummy. This is the recipe. Parsley, ground garlic, ground onion, salt, pepper, celery salt, thyme, and white pepper. Now you're going to need about 2 to 3 bouillon cubes to do the broth. For the chicken, you want to season it with onion and garlic powder with salt and pepper. That's it. And just cook it up. Now you're going to do your broth. Basically, you just take 1 to 2 tablespoons of each ingredient and just mix it all in there. So when you set aside your broth, you want to start defrosting your vegetables so that you can add it with the chicken. As you can see, the chicken is on the bottom. And I'm adding the veggies, the mixed veggies. This will make two medium pies. Your corn, your sugar snaps, your broccoli, your sweet peas, your carrots, whatever you like. So now you just add your broth in there. So that's your finished broth there. It takes about 5 minutes to make. You just taste as you go. Add salt if you need to get the taste that you like. I put more than enough salt because the salt is going to dilute into the veggies and the chicken. So it may taste bland after a while, and that's when you just add salt to it. You can add onion and garlic powder as well. Okay, just mix it around. Okay. I'm taking a cup and I'm filling it up about halfway. And I add about 2 tablespoons of cornstarch so I can start thickening up the broth. Now you can add 1 to 2 more tablespoons of cornstarch to make it thicker. And make sure your fire is at medium to low heat so the cornstarch will cook up in there and thicken up. And then you just add it. I like to add it in the middle. And then I just mix it in from the middle to the outer part. It really good. Now this is where you wait for about 2 to 3 minutes, see how it thickens up on medium to low heat. And if you want to add some cornstarch, just do the same thing. And then you just add some salt and pepper as you taste. Taste as you go. So you can bring out those nice flavors. We are like children. Okay, that's the pepper. Now, you just cover that. You mix it up and cover it. And while it's getting cooked up a little, you just start doing your pie crust. Now, we bought ours. You can make your own if you'd like. But we bought ours to make the time shorter in making it. And you just add the broth, you add the mixture into the pot. These are about medium sized pie pans. Can I get some greens and some blues? We're made by the pigment of paint that is. Now you don't want to overflow it, so you just want to kind of just stop at the top. And then you add the second layer of crust on top and get a fork and just kind of press the fork on the sides of the pan, and you take the knife and you take out the excess. Okay. Then you just poke holes on the top so that the steam and the juice can breathe in the oven. And this is the second one. My Lord did the first one. Yeah, I like to make like tic-tac-toe designs. So I do get the excess and I do my little tic-tac-toe design. Okay, now you just poke the holes so that the steam can come out of there in the oven. Now just put your oven to about 350 degrees, 350, for about 30 minutes so it can get to a nice golden brown. Okay, and there you have it, the finished product. Nice golden brown, nice and crusty like. Okay. So that's what your chicken pot pie should look like at the end. Okay. So like the video. Subscribe to the page. Comment on the bottom and let us know how this recipe went for you. How did it come out? Okay. Like Motley and Bearden, these masters of peace and life, layers of color and time. Step back. Okay, that's us serving the first slice. Now, as you will see, it's a little juicy. So, as I said in the beginning, you can add the cornstarch if you want it to thicken up a little more and you want it to stay together a little bit more. But nonetheless, it's still yummy. Oh, and when you leave it overnight, like the leftovers are banging because the seasoning just kind of soaks in. So enjoy, Israel. Shalom, Most High in Christ bless you.